Hello, everyone. This is Surfin' Sapo. One of the commenters asked, "Why do I always call my steaks fajitas?" Well, I don't call steaks fajitas. I call skirt steaks fajitas, because down here in South Texas, we've always called skirt steaks fajitas. And back when I started cooking them was 1982, and it barely before that they were grinding it up for hamburger meat. So let's just go ahead and take a review here. Fajita history. Texans would probably like to lay claim to the fajita, but history gives credit to Mexican ranch workers living in West Texas along the Rio Grande on the Texas-Mexican border. In the late 1930s or early 1940s, when a steer was butchered, the workers were given the least desirable parts to eat, partially payment for their wages. Because of this, the workers learned to make good of a tough cut of beef known as skirt steak. In Spanish, fajita is a form of the word faja, which translates to belt or girdle in English. Okay, that makes sense. The fajita is truly a Tex-Mex food, a blending of Texas cowboy and Mexican panchero foods. The Mexican term for the grilled skirt steak is arracheras, and the American counterpart is fajitas. Today, the term has completely lost its original meaning and has come to describe just about anything that is cooked and served rolled up in a flour tortilla. The only true fajitas, however, are made from the skirt steak. So that's why I call skirt steaks fajitas, whether I make tacos out of them. And I don't call chicken fajitas or shrimp fajitas, because it's part of the cow. The fajita is part of the cow. It's the skirt steak. This article here is a good article. Let me go a little further. I don't know how far we want to go with this, but let's go a little further. Sonny Falcon, meat market manager of Guajardo's Cash Grocery, liked to experiment with the ideas of using the tough skirt steak in recipes. According to the article, The Return of the Fajita King, in an interview with Sonny Falcon by Virginia B. Wood in the Austin Chronicle, March 5, 1995. Here's what Sonny said: "I looked at that cut of meat and said to myself, it looks like just like a belt." He says, "The first fajita I ever saw, I made myself right here in the 1960s, according to Falcon's version of fajita history. He figured his new creation would popularize an affordable cut of meat and attract more business to the family store if he could just get people to taste it. Anytime Dad would cook fajitas in the backyard, all our friends would ask to come over," recalls son John Falcon. Dad knew he'd come up on with something great. In 1969, Sonny set up a concession booth at a weekend outdoor event in Kyle, Texas. He also went to the rodeos, fairs, and outdoor festivals on nights, weekends, selling his fajita taco to the crowds of appreciative people. Sonny became personally identified with the dish by the late 1970s. An Austin reporter christened him the Fajita King, and the name stuck. Sonny now owns the trademark on that term. He also tried to trademark the word fajita, but was turned down. Okay, let's step below to the next paragraph. In 1948, Ninfa Rodriguez Lorenzo, a Mexican American woman, and her Italian American husband, Tommy Lorenzo, opened a tortilla and pizza dough factory in Houston. The factory wasn't succeeding, so they borrowed money and opened a Mexican restaurant called Ninfa's. Because the restaurant became so popular, they closed down the tortilla factory and concentrated on the restaurant. In around 1973, Ninfa's version of the fajita was created at the suggestion of a customer who had just returned from a trip from Mexico City and asked the staff to slice a piece of steak into thin strips so he could make an upscale taco. Once the accomplishments were added, cilantro, onion, tomatoes, chilies, sour cream, and cheese, the new fajita dish became a house specialty Originally called tacos al cabron, not cabron, cabron, it was later trademarked as tacos a la ninfa. Later, the restaurant began to use the term fajitas. Okay, let's go one more, and that's it. In 1982, Chef George Weidman, chef of the Hyatt Regency in Austin, Texas, in 1982, he recognized the commercial potential of a popular local Tex-Mex dish. He put sizzling fajitas on a menu of the Hyatt La Vista restaurant, and soon sales of that signature dish made it to the most profitable restaurants in the Hyatt chain. So there you have it, folks. No one's right and no one's wrong. I'm right because I go by the original name of the fajitas, the belt or the girdle, the skirt steak. And I grill them, and it's still, you know, we call it the cabron, tacos al carbon, not cabron. Anyway, and the commenter was also right too, because he's going by the new version. He's probably not from South Texas, so he's going from what he's learned through other YouTube videos and restaurants and commercials and whatnot like that. So we're both right and we're both wrong. So that was a great question there, a comment, sir. I appreciate it. And here's a nice web page to learn about that. The address is right here. What's Cooking America? History, Fajita History. So there you have it, folks. This is a great thing that we can do to share education with each other. And it's a good way to learn. And we don't have to degrade each other or belittle each other. We can educate each other. That's what it's all about, folks. So, Surf and Sopo signing off. God bless you, and hope to see y'all soon.